those of you that have been following this channel in the last week will have seen videos about the 49th RAGBRAI ride across Iowa. The purpose of publishing the videos on this channel is to demonstrate the collaboration between different people, that's the editors, the shooters, and the director, all in different locations. The shooters were in Iowa, and the editor in Sydney, Australia, and the director in Kansas City. This video will show you a behind-the-scenes making of the videos as a collaborative project using Final Cut Pro as the editing suite and a Dropbox business account as a location where the Final Cut Pro library containing the project was stored and edited. My name's Bruce, and if we've met before, welcome back. Otherwise, please like and subscribe and press the bell so that you can be notified about more videos about Final Cut Pro. The key to the collaboration is the positioning of the Final Cut Pro library within Dropbox on the internet and not on a physical computer. This allows the project to be viewed and edited from any location without having to be uploaded or downloaded because it's live on the internet at all times. It's just as if the computers are on the same network, in the same office, in the same city. The real beauty of editing in Dropbox is that when the edit's completed, it's almost immediately available to the other editors anywhere in the world, because the syncing's already happening while the edit's been in progress, with only the recent changes having to sync. And the added bonus is you don't need to export it, as all the editing is live in the library in Dropbox. Let's look at how the business Dropbox was set up. The default business account has three users. For the RAGBRAI event, we had two shooters, one editor, and one director. And that's four users. So how did we get on with this extra person? Well, the director and the editor took up two user accounts so that they could both edit the Final Cut Pro library. And the third user position was given to one of the shooters so they could upload their footage directly to the business Dropbox. The second shooter fortunately had his own independent Dropbox account that he uploaded to and sent the links to a WhatsApp group account. He could have used any cloud service, and as you'll see later in this tutorial, I'll show you how to use those as well. Clips in any Dropbox account can be seamlessly transferred to the business Dropbox account without having to download them to a computer, and then that second Dropbox opens up automatically to show the transferred files. It's a similar process for video clips that have been uploaded to the cloud services like Mega or iCloud, and they can be set to download direct to Dropbox also. I'll show you when I demonstrate the process in a minute. Communication. Mentioning the WhatsApp account brings up a real consideration about communication. Communication is the key to everyone being on the same page, and WhatsApp's perfect for this, though other cloud services will be fine. It's particularly important, if possible, for shooters uploading footage to advise when they're starting an upload, how many files they're sending, and when they see the upload completed. So always tell the WhatsApp group what you're doing at any time. Folder organization. The next consideration is the file organization in Dropbox, and there are two ways to look at this. First of all, what the shooter sees. Just have one folder for them to upload to. And then secondly, where the actual footage is organized for the editor, the shooter's folder. Number one is to not confuse the shooter, who's uploading the video clips, with a nested file structure. They're likely stressing to get a good Wi-Fi upload location, so don't need to be confused as to where to upload their video. It's best to have an obvious folder in Dropbox for just the shooters to upload to. And I'd refer to that as a bucket to dump everything into without them having to think about it. And then once they've uploaded their clips, then the editor can move the files to his appropriate folders. It's from the editor's folders that they're imported into Final Cut Pro. Again, I'll show you what I demonstrated in a minute. The added advantage of the bucket approach is that after the bucket folder has been emptied and moved to the other organization folders, any extra or slow to upload clips will show up in the bucket folder later. And this means the editor can easily recognize that they're extras and not miss out on them. The shooter is the first editor. There's a fine balance between too much footage and not enough to complete the edit. The shooter needs to be aware that what they shoot needs to be pertinent without being too lean. Too much footage means too big a file and the download times will be too long. And it's got to be said that the hardest thing for you to control is the internet itself. So stress that as little as possible while still having enough footage to fill the edit. And this is how it works. Now it's time to demonstrate the process in Dropbox. In this exercise, you'll see the bucket folders in uppercase, so they're easily visible for the shooter to upload to. The editor's folder organization, because there are 8 days in this event, each day has a main folder. And these contained folders for each shooter. So let's look at shooter one. There are the folders for the iPhone, external audio, drone, and the action cam. And these folders are always left exposed so you can see their contents at a glance. And after the footage is imported into Final Cut Pro, the folder's closed as a check that the footage has been imported. And if you're in doubt whether the clips have been imported, try to import again. Final Cut Pro will not duplicate the clips if it's already got them. You'll also see here the Final Cut Pro library, which is created in Final Cut Pro and then stored here. I'll show you that again in a minute. And finally, there's a folder called Edit Resources, and that's for everything to do with that day other than the shooter's footage. You'll see that the Shooter 2 folder has the same contents, and the video clips are dragged from whatever position they come when Dropbox transfers them. Transferring clips from a cloud account. Now I'll show you how to access those video clips for Shooter 2. Once you've received the Dropbox link, clicking it will open in the shooter's Dropbox. There you can select the folder that you want to transfer. Once you've opened the folder, you can only transfer all of the files contained in that folder. And this means that any further files are added later, you'll be forced to transfer the first lot again. It's no drama, but it just adds extra sync time. Click the Download to Dropbox button, and it'll tell you where it's going. Press Save, and the second Dropbox will open at that folder. You can then drag them to any other folder in Dropbox. If you use Mega, you'll be able to set the destination folder as in Dropbox, and this will most likely apply for other cloud services as well. Select the files to transfer, click the Download button at the bottom of the window, and then nominate the folder in your Dropbox that you want to transfer to. Now in your Dropbox, you'll be able to access that file. Dropbox static icons. Now let's look at the symbols in Dropbox that'll tell you what state the files are in. To be clear, the labels relate to your user account. Other users could be different. The status labels are to the right. A green tick means it's available for your user account to access. The blue recycle sign means that it's being synced. But if you were the uploader, you'll probably still be able to access it. But other users will not be able to access it. The grey cloud icon means it's stored in the cloud and you don't have immediate access to it. If you right click on the files from a grey cloud, you'll be able to make available offline. And this could take some time to be available to you. That depends on the file size and the speed of your connection. When you right click, you'll also likely see Make Online Only. And this will remove the file from your computer, but keep it online. When does Dropbox store on your computer? It's important to note how Dropbox uses storage space on your computer's hard disk. If the tick is green, it means that the file is stored on your computer as well as online with Dropbox. If the status is a grey cloud, It's not taking up space on your computer and will take some time to sync from online should you right-click and select Make Available Offline. And a little tip, be sure you understand what online only means and what offline means. Online is only on Dropbox, and offline is on Dropbox as well as your computer. Traffic lights. I've personalized the status system a little further to use the Mac's color coding to indicate whether a Final Cut Pro library is available to view or not. Final Cut Pro is good at locking files, so two people can't access a file at the same time. But using Dropbox seemed to be a little different consideration due to any internet lag. I feel it's safer for the editor to claim ownership of the library while editing and then releasing the ownership once the edit is finished. And on this basis, the library has a red traffic light while editing is in progress and then it's changed to green when the edits are finished. The Final Cut Pro library. In Final Cut, create a new library and store in Dropbox, in this case, in each day's folder. Go to the location in Dropbox and colour the file as red by right-clicking. When importing, I prefer to have files stored in the library. It takes up more Dropbox space, but ensures that the files don't show the red warning when opened by another computer. In Final Cut Pro's preferences, make sure that the copy to library storage location is ticked. Files can be imported into Final Cut Pro's projects by either dragging or using the import window. It's over to you. From here, edit the footage. No need to save to Dropbox, as the actual edit is happening within Dropbox on the internet. Plugins. All computers accessing the Dropbox file will need the same plugins. That's titles, effects, transitions, and generators. And this is a responsibility of the principal editor to make sure that the plugins are common to all the computers. And of course, any subsequent editors not to use plugins that are not on other computers. To be safe here, you could just use plugins supplied by Apple as part of the Final Cut Pro package. If in doubt, think of it this way. If whatever you're doing in the edit is part of the default Final Cut Pro package, both computers will be able to view it. Fonts. Preferably only use Apple supplied fonts or those you know are common to all the computers being used. If you use a font you're not sure of, grab a copy from your user library. Take a note of its name before you go to the user folder. Fonts can be stored on your computer in two locations, the system library or the user library. And you can take a copy of the font by holding the option key and dragging it to the appropriate Dropbox folder. And a word of warning about copyright issues when copying fonts. Consolidate library media. Before you sign off on the edit, select the library, go to the file menu and consolidate library media. Go to the Dropbox location for the library and change the traffic light from red to green. Then advise on WhatsApp that the edit is complete and available for other people to view. Optionally, if you wanted to conserve hard disk space on your computer after the edit's completed, right-click on the library in Dropbox and select Make Online Only. Relinking RED missing files. Providing the editor has consolidated the library media, you'll be unlikely to see the red warning missing file sign. But if you do, this is how to relink it. Select the missing clips, and from the file menu, select Relink Files. Select Original Media. In the window, select the missing button and highlight the files. Press Locate All. Navigate to the Dropbox and select a folder that you feel the file may be in. Final Cut Pro is quite intelligent and will look in nested folders so you don't have to go too deep to find the actual file. And if you don't find it, contact the last person to edit the library and see if they remembered to consolidate the library. a damage library. If you open a library from Dropbox into Final Cut Pro and get a warning that the library is damaged, this means that it's likely online only or has not synced yet. The only resource here is to check Make Offline and wait. And one final thing, and the internet. From a practical point of view, one thing is impossible to control, and that's the internet itself. Shooters will have to duck and dive to find a good Wi-Fi signal or use slow cell phone data. And from the editor's position, he'll be guessing as to when the clips are going to be synced, wondering if all have uploaded to Dropbox or have some dropped out. How long will they take to come down? It's a matter of continually checking, which is so time consuming. And as you can see, there's some challenges. But as I said before, the real beauty in editing in Dropbox is when the edit is completed, it's almost immediately available to another editor anywhere in the world, because the syncing has been happening while the edit's been in progress, with only the recent changes having to sync later. There's a lot of information contained here. It's not difficult, but you do need to keep your wits about you. After you've done a few collaborative projects, you'll quickly get used to it. And good luck. And if you've enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe and press the bell so that you can be notified about more videos about Final Cut Pro.